Here in Raleigh, North Carolina, absolutely gorgeous for mid-February as temperatures reach near 80 degrees outside of Reynolds Coliseum. We're here at Kay Yao Court as the legendary coach. His statue sits just outside the building. NC State and Virginia Tech is next. We welcome you inside Reynolds Coliseum. You're watching women's college basketball on the ACC Network Extra. 17th ranked NC State host Virginia Tech in a big time ACC showdown. The Wolfpack 8-3 in the conference, Virginia Tech at 3-8. I'm Andrew Sanders, joined by Cody Burke. Glad to have you along for this afternoon's broadcast. Cody, we'll take a look at those ACC standings and the two records are reflexive here for NC State and Virginia Tech, but both teams with a lot to play for, trying to improve their ACC tournament standing.
Absolutely. Only a couple games left in the ACC. Both teams trying to get significant wins to get them a good seed in the ACC tournament, where it's anybody's game.
NC State looking for that double bye if they can lock up the four seed. Virginia Tech looking to improve. Here's a look at the ACC scoreboard. We'll look at that throughout this afternoon. A lot of ranked teams in action today the conference, and all of them are at home, so they'll be heavy favorites. No exception here between NC State and Virginia Tech. The Wolfpack ranked and at home going up against the Hokies, and NC State controls the tip. We're underway. And before the shot, we're going to have an offensive foul on Chelsea Nelson, and she was a moving screen.
I love the matchup of Hicks on Maya Spencer, both two quick, dynamic point guards.
So a turnover starts things off for NC State. You get a look at the Virginia Tech starting lineup. Good bounce pass inside. Able to find Reagan McGarity. And the Hokies are on the board. McGarity, one of the go-to players for Virginia Tech, part of really their big three. We'll talk about that in a few minutes.
Excellent
Maya
drive.
Spencer finishes.
Excellent drive by Maya Spencer, as always. So quick with that first step to get to the basket. You also have Virginia Tech using a 4-out-1-in system, very similar to NC State.
Jeanette Hicks lost her footing, got rid of it. Shot by Brooks off the left iron. Kendall Brooks, the freshman, off the mark, and breaking the other way is NC State. It's a post touch for Chelsea Nelson. She'll knock it down.
Excellent turnaround jumper by Chelsea Nelson.
NC State using that 4-out-1-in offense. Nelson is the one, and they really go to her when they need a basket. McGarity put it on the floor, nearly had her pass intercepted by Jennifer Mathurin. McGarity had her pocket picked. It was Mathurin who got her hand in.
I can admire McGarity with her ability to put the ball on the floor, even with her height.
They're into the basket, and it's McGarity. These players, both number 11s, already all over each other in this game.
And both similar type players to say they both can shoot the outside shot, put the ball on the floor, and finish near the rim.
Get a look at the Virginia Tech resume, and that's why this game, Cody, not just important for ACC tournament position a couple of games down the road. It's also important for NCAA tournament reasons. NC State, they know that they're going to be in the tournament with the quality wins they've had this season, but Virginia Tech is right now, in Charlie Cream's latest prediction on ESPN, one of the first 4-out teams. So if they could get this type of win, a ranked win on the road, it would really help them get into that tournament.
Absolutely, especially when you consider their previous wins earlier in the season.
Foul on NC State's Chelsea Nelson. That's already a quick two on her, and so Akilah Mays will have to check in. The senior forward, Sydney Cook, goes to the line.
Yeah, Sydney Cook, second in scoring, second in rebounds, also a senior.
And she's from North Carolina. She's from Parkton.
Okay. another reason for her to play well in their home state to help her team get them to the NCAA tournament.
Second free throw good. And so Cook cuts the NC State lead to just two. The story for Virginia Tech, they were outstanding in the non-conference, second best start in school history, as they were a perfect 13-0 outside of the league and started the year 15-1.
Yeah, a couple of significant losses, but can't really fault them for the tough ACC schedule.
They started 3-1 in the conference. They have lost seven in a row to go to 3-8. Good look inside, and there's Cook again with two more.
Cook did an excellent job of stealing Jennifer Mathurin, containing her from the interception.
It's a blocking foul. Dominique Wilson put it on the deck. She pulled over Sammy Hill. And that's the first foul on Hill.
I really do like the matchup of Spencer and Hicks. Again, both similar type players.
Mays misses from point blank range. Fight for the loose ball as it rolls out to Wilson. Spencer a little head fake. And a reverse lay-in is good.
Spencer so good off the dribble.
Good post position inside. McGarity had her shot swatted by Akilah Mays. You see that wingspan at 6'5". She takes up a lot of space, makes it hard to shoot over.
Exactly, and I love how Akilah Mays just strictly put her hands up. No leaning. That height serves as a gift for her.
So Virginia Tech's just at 3-8 in the conference again, still in that NCAA tournament picture. And a chance here for a quality road win to really bump up that resume. There's a three from McGarity. And the Hokies lead it.
Gotta love a post player with range. It's very hard to guard.
Dominique Wilson, nice move, no finish. Sammy Hill with the board. Hicks looks inside, and that's just too easy.
That NC State got confused as to who was guarding who on defense, just a lack of communication.
Cook has six for the Hokies, McGarity has five. And Tech leads by three. Maya Spencer will try a three. In and out. Offensive rebound to Mays. She'll recycle it. Spencer absorbs the contact, and they're going to count
and
the
they
basket.
They're going to count it just like in the NBA.
A little continuation.
We'll take it. Wow. Two players provide contact on Spencer. She's still finished.
The foul went against Shanette Hicks. It's her first foul. So Maya Spencer gets a chance to go to the line for the three-point play. Spencer, the first NC State player in history, a storied program. First player in history to have 1,400 points and 450 assists in a career. It has been an excellent one for her.
And luckily for her, many more games to still be played.
Right.
And continue climbing up those record boards.
Hokies by one. Hicks keeps the bounce alive with the right hand. She'll pull up from 15 feet and drain it.
Hicks only a sophomore, but the team leans on her for veteran leadership already.
Wilson, marked by Hill, spins away.
Oh, excellent defense on Dominique Wilson, recognizing she is a threat on the perimeter and driving to the basket.
Dee Dee Rogers looks inside to Nene Cole, and her pocket's picked by Hicks. And then she is fouled. That is what Shanette Hicks does. Second in the nation, 98 steals on the year, make it 99. And she took it away from Nene Cole, and that's the first whistle under 5 minutes, which means we'll take Our media timeout for the first quarter. The Hokies off to a good start on the road. They lead it 13-10 at the break. Welcome back, everyone. For K-Tech on the road with the early lead over 17-ranked NC State alongside Cody Burke. I'm Andrew Sanders. Cody, we spoke about the Hokies tournament resume. They're one of the first four teams out. Let's take a look now at NC State's resume. And the Wolfpack have built a very formidable resume this year. They've had a ton of quality wins. We talk about Notre Dame, only the second team in the ACC to have beaten Notre Dame. At Florida State in Tallahassee, home against Duke, on the road against Louisville. Those are some of the best wins that anyone can boast of in the country.
Yeah, very interesting. Notre Dame, Duke, and FSU are placed right above NC State in the ACC standings. And comes to show anybody's given in one given night, anyone can win.
Absolutely. And so NC State right now a four seed, but as you say, they are the only team to have beaten Florida State, the only team to have beaten Notre Dame in conference. Duke has three losses, and so they're looking to build. There's the Virginia Tech head coach, Kenny Brooks, in his first season. What a season it has been, getting off to that 13-0 start in the non-conference. Quality win over Tennessee. They beat Nebraska in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Jeanette Hicks, good drive. Missed everything but the backboard, and a jump ball will keep the possession on this end.
Such a quick step by Hicks in that previous play.
NC State, both fourth in the ACC and fourth, a four seed, according to Charlie Cream in his latest bracketology projection.
And what an opportunity to play NCAA tournament at your home court.
Panousis, splash from the wing. Virginia Tech's largest lead is now six. Spencer will curl to the basket, little out of control. Last touch by NC State, or pardon me, by Virginia Tech.
And you can see how Maya Spencer's being aggressive, attacking Hicks, possibly trying to get her into foul trouble.
Hicks already has one. Good look inside. And off the inbounds play, that's a little too easy for NC State.
A little too easy, but it's those easy little buckets that count when it comes down to the line.
Panousis. She'll try another three, and this one misses poorly. Boarded up by Dee Dee Rogers. Rogers coming off a really nice game her last time out. Nene Cole, good size inside.
Excellent for Nene Cole to use her body and her power to finish right at the rim.
NC State showing some depth in the front court as Hicks misses short. Looking ahead, Wilson, nice catch. She's fouled by Panousis and will go to the free throw line. You can see the senior connection, not afraid to push the ball in transition.
Mm-hmm. And you speak about Dee Dee Rogers earning some credibility, earning her some playing minutes. She had to step up for Jennifer Mathurin against Georgia Tech.
Wilson misses a free throw, and that is rare. An 87.5% free throw shooter on the season. She was a perfect 8 of 8. Last time out against Georgia Tech.
It was a nice homecoming from her.
And getting to play in Atlanta?
Absolutely. Her and Maya Spencer.
Second free throw good. And the Hokie lead is just one. Seen a pretty good first quarter so far, and that's about what we expected, even though, you know, NC State 8-3 in the league, Virginia Tech, as Hicks, I think, got away with a walk, shuffled her feet. Mm-hmm. Virginia Tech just 3-8. But the league is so tough, exactly. There's really not that much of a margin, much of a difference.
I cannot let that record fool you in the ACC.
Panousis missed it. And NC State found that out. on the road in Chapel Hill recently. Really the only bad loss on the schedule for the Wolfpack. And they followed that up with a great road win at Louisville. Solid road win in Atlanta against Georgia Tech, and they're happy to be back home. Rogers, that's for three. Offensive rebound. Cole, oh, if she had looked up, no one was between her and the basket. And a little shake of the head from Wes Moore.
Yeah, very interesting, but NC State gets another opportunity set up, convert for 2 or 3 points.
I think she just lost where she was on the floor when she took that contact.
Yeah. Sometimes you can be very surprised how open you are.
That's right. Hicks trying to get it inside. Instead, it's Panousis. Gets her own board after it was tipped, and she'll score it with a friendly roll.
Yeah, Panousis, not a very big guard in size, but just follows her shot and gets an offensive rebound.
Wilson gets a screen from Cole, shouldered off by Nakadil. And a close range miss leads to a Hokie break. They work it all the way around, whistle. And this is a clock issue. The shot clock was running, and I think that they're discussing the game clock right now. The officials will look at the monitor.
As you know, Andrew, every second counts. So we have to make sure the clock is right in the ACC.
Again, we expected this one to be close. That's what we've gotten so far. Virginia Tech, and we mentioned NC State beating Louisville on the road. Virginia Tech just played there on Thursday, or at home, I should say, against Louisville. And really played the Cardinals closely. It was just a 2-point game going into the fourth quarter before Louisville was able to pull away. They ended up winning by 18. But Virginia Tech, again, looking to break that losing streak that's now at 7 games. I think that effort through 3 quarters against Louisville kind of gives them hope going into this road game. They know they just have to finish better.
Yep, absolutely. And then NC State, you know, barely beat Louisville. I mean, to win nonetheless, but can't sleep on Virginia Tech in the ACC, that's for sure.
The Wolfpack with all of those quality wins, as we mentioned, that means that really the toughest part of their conference schedule is already behind them, and with their remaining schedule, which we'll talk about later in the broadcast, but including this game, that means 5 games left in conference, and they'll be favored in all 5. McGarity, not this time. Already knocked one down. As we creep under a minute to go here in the first quarter. Again, they'll get Cole a touch. Getting some good minutes. And a good move.
Wow. That just shows Nene Cole's power, backing McGarity all the way nearly under the basket. A little bait and switch to finish 2 points.
Really shows Wes Moore's offensive style. This is an NC State team that makes 8 threes per game. Not takes, but makes 8 threes per game. So they have outside shooters, but whether it's Chelsea Nelson or if she's in foul trouble, they can go to other post players and they still look to get meaningful touches in there. Good bucket by Sammy Hill. And Virginia Tech in this first quarter, they took a 9-8 lead. They have not looked back since then. They've been leading, it's about midway through the quarter. Pull up. Spencer. She's so quick with that pull up, able to knock it down in front of Panousis. But it's Virginia Tech who has the 1-point lead as we go to the second quarter. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes on the ACC Network Extra. Back here on the ACC Network Extra along with Cody Burke. I'm Andrew Sanders. Glad you could tune in for this Sunday matinee between the Hokies and the Wolfpack. This is the 18th all-time meeting. NC State leads the series 16-1 overall. So it has been a series that has been dominated by the Wolfpack. However, the Hokies' only win did come fairly recently, a couple of years back Actually, in the first round of the ACC tournament, they got a buzzer beater from Hannah Young to defeat the Wolfpack. But NC State, coached by Wes Moore in his fourth season, other than that one game, have had all kinds of success. Looking to, obviously, protect their home court here against the Hokies this afternoon. This is the first matchup with the Hokies with Kenny Brooks at the helm. And Coach Brooks coming off 11 great seasons at James Madison. He is the winningest coach in their history. Made postseason appearances in all 11 of his season. 6 NCAA tournament appearances, 5 WNITs. And so Virginia Tech, a team on the rise, really excited about the start of his tenure.
Absolutely, and the win here could get him in his first season to the NCAA tournament, which is an awesome accomplishment.
Absolutely, the Hokies with the ball and the lead. Their first position in the second quarter, and as I say that, Wilson takes it away, and there goes the lead as well.
I know Coach Moore is grinning from ear to ear. He loves when guards on the perimeters can deny their defenders the reversal. That's exactly what Dominique Wilson did.
It's the second Virginia Tech turnover, and that's something they do extremely well. Good defense by DeeDee Rogers there. In the pack, breaking. That's going to be the second foul on Hicks, and she can't believe it. She thought she got all ball.
Check the replay right here. I don't know. What are you thinking, Andrew?
Yeah, I think that looked pretty clean. Remember, Hicks is one of the best pickpockets in all the country, second in the nation. That would have been her 100th steal of the season.
That's what she's known for. We'll see if Kenny Brooks will keep her in the game, even with these two fouls.
Ashley Williams cans the first free throw. Hey, you don't pick up that many steals unless you know how to play good defense without fouling. Uh-huh. So I think that's an interesting thing to look at here. And it looks like, at least for the time being, Coach Brooks is going to stick with Hicks. Hicks will fire over Spencer. Missed it short. Rebound. Here goes to Maya Spencer. Maya Spencer's having herself a good game so far. Already 8 points, 4 rebounds, and a couple of assists.
And again, with each game Maya Spencer plays, she's just climbing up the record.
And Hicks is still guarding her. Rogers, an open three. Bank is open on Sunday.
I'll say, only this bank, huh?
You know that only counts if you call it.
Yeah, I think she called it in her mind.
She must have. They put it up on the board. Hokies miss another one. And NC State has been good on the defensive glass so far. Spencer. Nope, and here comes Hicks. Watch out, full head of steam. Goes around Williams, can't get the basket, but she will draw the foul.
You see how quick Jeanette is with her speed getting all the way to the rim, short matter of seconds.
Jeanette Hicks, not just the leading defender, the leading scorer at 16 and a half points per game. Makes the first free throw. Here come three new Wolfpack players. Akila Mays, Jennifer Mathurin, and Kayla Ely seeing her first minutes. Virginia Tech will bring in number 35, Tara Nakadil. And Panousis is also at the scorer's table. She's waiting to come in for Hicks. So Coach Brooks did give Jeanette a couple of minutes. Now she's going to check out if she makes this free throw.
I think that's very strategic of Kenny Brooks.
So Kayla Ely will bring the ball up. Redshirt freshman guard. And she'll go to drive. That touched every part of the rim before it rolled out.
Every part of the rim had to get a kiss of it. Yeah, Kayla Ely also very quick first step, knows how to attack the rim. She draws a foul and is being rewarded for it by going to the free throw line.
The foul is on Kendall Brooks. That's her first. So what have you seen offensively from NC State so far? Because to me it seems like they've really made it an emphasis to get post players inside touches and get guards into that lane. Everything's going through the paint.
Absolutely. I noticed that the guards are attacking the rim. Just seems like the team is really focusing on that high field goal percentage shot closer to the rim.
So Ely, she drove it in there, got fouled, missed both free throws. Knock it in to Sammy Hill. She looks to put it on the deck.
See McGarity calling for it.
Just a right-handed hook shot, turning over that left shoulder. Spencer to the cup. Just shows you, after an NC State defensive rebound, the alarm bells have got to be going off for Virginia Tech. They didn't get back.
Uh-huh. I could definitely tell Coach Morris telling the team to push the ball every possession.
There's a turnover. More fast break points.
Zach Abadji, Kenny Brooks is calling a timeout.
Virginia Tech is the best in the ACC. They have the fewest turnovers, but first a defensive rebound, run out, and then the turnover lead to four NC State fast break points. They lead it by eight as we go to break. Andrew Sanders and Cody Burke back with you here in Raleigh, North Carolina at Reynolds Coliseum. NC State with its largest lead now, stretching it out to 8 points. Cody, the Wolfpack able to turn defense into offense.
Yep, NC State is pushing the ball. They are taking a high percentage shots, meaning they're getting the ball inside and attacking the rim for easy 2 points.
Maya Spencer really fueling that little run with a couple of transition buckets, leading Kenny Brooks to call a timeout. You mentioned that high percentage shot, Cody. The Wolfpack has taken just 4 3-pointers so far, and that's well under what they average almost through one half.
Absolutely. I guess NC State's realizing you can't really live by the three, so taking that higher percentage shots.
Cook will hand off to Hicks, who is back in there. She immediately puts it on the deck. Shot was blocked, the help defense from Akilah Mays, but Hicks goes right to the free throw line. And, you know, Cody, at least to me, the couple of possessions when she was out offensively, things got bogged down. The ball got turned over, and you see immediately Coach Brooks says, I got to have my best scorer back out there.
Yeah, and it's amazing that she's only a sophomore and what impact she makes to the Virginia Tech team.
And again, that's part of Virginia Tech being this team that is rising and getting better in a very good conference. The future is bright with Hicks as a sophomore. You see, she nearly got in there and stole that ball from Wilson after she rebounded it.
That is what she is known for.
Better than four steals per game. So Virginia Tech now coming out of the timeout, Cody, they've changed up their defense.
Yep. And the change in the defense is because Kenny Brooks is realizing that they are attacking the rim. You have to contain the paint. So switching to a zone is the solution to it.
Makes picture dribble up, has to get it somewhere, looks inside, and it's turned over. She overpassed McGarity. Inside.
I love how Keelan Mays used her height. She kept the ball very high. Just a quick turnaround, finished with 2 points.
Good post player fundamentals from from Mays. And a late whistle is going to draw the ire of the fans here. Sydney Cook will go to the free throw line. Mathurin bumped her.
In my eyes, Mathurin did a good job of keeping her hands up, straight up. But Cook does a good job of putting her body into Jennifer Mathurin and getting the call.
Sydney Cook, since 6'2". And this is the first free throw. Virginia Tech now 4 of 7 in this contest from the line. She goes one of two. And that gets the Hokies back within single digits.
And now you'll see they're in the 2-2-1 press, trying to put some pressure on NC State, hopefully getting turnovers to convert to points.
I really like that from Coach Brooks. Just as NC State made a run, switching everything up, just giving them a different look. It was becoming a little too simple offensively for the Wolfpack. This is a new puzzle to solve. Inside. The ball movement is too good for NC State. Wilson to Mays.
And Akilah Mays just has improved so much in each year that she's played, getting more comfortable with her height.
Panousis will score it. A big three, and the Hokies needed that one.
With a very quick release.
Thurin draws the contact. Again, it's the two number 11s going at it, and that should be the second foul on McGarity. It is. And so foul trouble has been a problem really for both teams. Chelsea Nelson of NC State got a quick two fouls. She hasn't been back since about the 7-minute mark of the first quarter. And now Hicks and McGarity, two of the Virginia Tech big three, both have two fouls. The third member of that big three, as number three, Maya Spencer, the leader of NC State, comes back in, is Sydney Cook. Back to a 10-point lead. Hill will try a corner three. She missed everything.
Well, that was a perfect opportunity. McGarity drew two defenders, leaving Hill open for three.
Kayla Ely's going to work it out, and you have a three-second call, I believe. Must have been on Mays.
Yeah, I couldn't quite catch that. Interesting matchup, Kayla Ely now on Hicks, as opposed to Maya Spencer, who started the game on her.
Hill drives, no. Cook had it knocked away, and Ely is fouled. And who is this going to be on? Is it Hill?
That is a great question.
It will be Sammy Hill called for the foul, and so she has two fouls. That's now three Hokie starters with two fouls, and still about 4 minutes to go here before halftime. This is not a tremendously deep Virginia Tech team. Just seven players have played so far. Wide open three for Spencer. Missed it badly.
Excellent box out by McGarity, keeping Akilah Mays away from the ball.
That's the danger, isn't it, for Coach Brooks going zone, as NC State's such a good three-point shooting team. But so far, it has worked out. Pack has been able to generate a couple of open looks at it.
Yeah, NC State's having a difficult time getting Akilah Mays the ball. Virginia Tech containing the middle.
Mays will turn. Rebounded by Hicks. She'll immediately go full speed ahead. Ely is in there. Last touched by number two in white. A couple of Hokies will come in as Hill and McGarity, both with two fouls, will come out. Nakadil is in. As is Kendall Brooks. Three on the way from Hicks.
Yeah, Hicks not really known for that three-point shot, but that was what was an opportunity for her.
Dominique Wilson with a basket and the foul. State adds to its lead. This is now the largest at 12.
Again, that starts with NC State pushing the ball up the court.
And it hasn't really been mostly by the dribble. It's been that throw-ahead pass.
Yeah, exactly. And you have players running the floor.
Coaches will always tell you that the ball can travel faster with a pass over the dribble. At least that's what they tell dribble-happy guards.
Yeah.
Three-point play by Dominique Wilson, and it's 39-26 Wolfpack. So even with Coach Brooks switching things up defensively, NC State really playing nicely on the offensive end.
Yeah, absolutely.
Already 39 points, but still 2.5 minutes left. Cook had it taken away.
And I think that's what starts the run, Andrew, is turnovers converting to points, as shown here.
Timeout, Virginia Tech. ...42-26 NC State, and again, it's a transition bucket, but this time, it's Jennifer Mathurin for three, and NC State showing that that offense is multifaceted and dangerous in so many ways.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if you're Coach Brooks in this huddle right now, obviously Wes Moore likes what he's seen. If you're Coach Brooks, and there he is, a look at the first-year head coach. What are you telling your team? You've got foul trouble. You've already gone zone. And just no matter what he tries, it seems like NC State is still being efficient.
Absolutely. I would think that Kenny Brooks is telling Virginia Tech to be patient, get the ball inside. Virginia Tech was effective when they were able to get the ball inside. McGarity and Cook could convert for 2 points.
McGarity back in the game. They try to get her a look. Well defended. So I think that was the message. I think you're all over it, Cody. But another Virginia Tech turnover and a block by Nacogdoil. It'll still be NC State ball, but Nacogdoil preventing the basket.
I mean, that last possession, it was a good look for Virginia Tech, but Jennifer Mathurin just did an excellent job of denying that lob pass.
I told you, as Wilson misses, last touch, it'll stay on this end again. I told you that Virginia Tech leads the ACC in turnovers, but they're top 10 in the NCAA in turnovers per game. They lead the NCAA in fewest turnovers overall. But NC State, the three ball wasn't falling early. Now it is, and things are starting to steamroll. 19-point advantage. McGarity puts it on the deck. Cross-court pass. It won't fall for Brooks.
Excellent box out position by Keela Mays. Mai Spencer pushing the ball. That's what they like to do.
Ashley Williams, she'll try it again.
And so all of a sudden, the three-point shot's falling for NC State. The crowd is feeling it.
Hicks has it rim out. Fight for the ball. Possession arrow favoring the Hokies. NC State is on a 14-0 run over the last 3 minutes and 36 seconds. Kayla Kinder will check in for Nacogdoil. Coach Brooks just looking for a spark. Everything's too tough being forced by Virginia Tech. And when you get in a drought, Cody, it's easy, especially on the road, to panic a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And you have to give credit to NC State's defense, you know, staying low, being in their face. And, I mean, it's tough for Virginia Tech. We'll see what they could come out of this.
And things go from bad to worse for the Hokies because after that rebound by Mathurin, Hicks just picked up her third foul. So not only is it a foul that comes, you know, 90 feet away from the basket and leads to 2 free throws for a good free throw shooter, but it's the third foul on the leading scorer, Hicks, just before the stroke of halftime.
Yeah, very odd from a team that does not foul quite often.
We saw a tight first quarter. Virginia Tech actually had the lead 20-19 at the end of the first quarter. The second quarter has belonged to the Wolfpack. McGarity finally ends the run, 16-0 run now over, and the scoring drought of 4 minutes.
I love the versatility of McGarity. She can shoot the outside shot. Obviously, she's a post player and can take it off the dribble.
And a three finally doesn't go down for NC State. Hill looks to Coach Brooks and gets the call. A 1 second differential between game and shot clock.
Now with Hicks on the game, I wonder what strategy Kenny Brooks is communicating to his team as to who's going to get the final shot off.
Hill will go with about 7 seconds. Good hedge from Cole. Gets into the corner, just tried to pass it off Cole.
Again, that NC State defense that's in your face and could come as a surprise.
And only one on the shot clock. Benusis, they're going to wave that off. Still in her hand, and so there's 1.4 left. Spencer, that was still in her hand. It will not count. So we'll go to the halftime locker room, 50-28. Cody, NC State ends the half in the last 4.5 minutes on a 16-2 run. That's what good teams do at home.
That's when we take advantage of turnovers, pushing the ball, converting to easy points. The three ball is falling now. Seems like all is going well for NC State.
We'll take a break and be back in just a couple of minutes for the halftime show here from Reynolds Coliseum. Wolfpack up 22 in Raleigh. Halftime here in Reynolds Coliseum. You're watching women's college basketball here on the ACC Network Extra. NC State with a 50-28 advantage at the halftime break. Hello, everyone. We welcome you courtside here in Reynolds Coliseum. Andrew Sanders and Cody Burke with you. So glad you could join us here on Sunday afternoon. Cody, 22-point lead for the Wolfpack here at home against Virginia Tech. We'll take a look now across the ACC and some scoreboards from across the league. Again, a lot of teams in action here on Sunday. There's a look at it. Notre Dame already beat Georgia Tech. And again, all the ranked teams are at home.
As predicted, you can imagine that the ranked teams, the higher seeds in the ACC, are taking advantage of their last few games and solidifying their chances of a high seed in the ACC.
The only non-ranked matchup, Virginia and Wake Forest. And right now, the Cavaliers doubling up the Demon Deacs at halftime in Charlottesville. Now for a look at the ACC standings. Again, NC State has been one of the biggest surprises, not just in the conference, but in the country so far this year at 8-3, looking to go 9-3 and match up with Duke. And they do have the tiebreaker against the Blue Devils. Again, there's still several games left. Virginia Tech at 3-8, looking for that really quality road win. You see they're tied 10th right now with Georgia Tech and Pittsburgh, but as you see, they're just a couple of games out from Wake Forest to be on that left side of the graphic, and that's where those top eight teams are going to be.
Exactly, and these last few games matter so much because they won a higher seed to get placed into the ACC tournament. And like you said, Virginia Tech looking for that quality road win to help them with the NCAA tournament eventually.
No doubt about it. So we've still got a couple of games left. Looking forward to those. Virginia Tech's upcoming schedule, see what they have remaining. At Pittsburgh, couple of home games, and at Boston College. You see, those are both winnable road games. And then Virginia, Miami at home, got to protect your home court. They're going to be looking for some revenge against the Cavaliers. It was a 50-point blowout when they visited Charlottesville. You know, in a rivalry matchup, they're going to be out for blood.
Absolutely. And Miami, that senior day, the Virginia Tech team has four seniors. That's even more motivation for them to get another top quality road win and finish the season strong.
Again, they're in the first four out right now, just trying to play their way into the NCAA tournament as well. For NC State, as I mentioned earlier, 8-3 in the league. They have a 22-point lead at halftime, and the rest of the way, a couple of very winnable road games, and then home against Wake Forest in North Carolina. They've been through the gauntlet. Not that you can really take a night off in the ACC, because we know how difficult it is, but they'll be favored the rest of the way.
Yeah, absolutely. And the way NC State is playing today, they could keep that same momentum. They'll be in good standings.
All right. We're going to hit a break here on the ACC Network Extra. When we return, we'll look at highlights and stats from the first half. Our score at the half, NC State 50, Virginia Tech 28. Halftime here in Reynolds Coliseum. 17th-ranked NC State, looking every bit a ranked team, as they scored 31 points in the second quarter to pull away from Virginia Tech. They lead it by 22 at halftime. It's time now to take a look at some of the highlights from the first half, and there were some really nice highlights for NC State. Maya Spencer really set the tone early with her ability to get into the lane and score.
And that's what she does so well. Quick first step. She knows how to draw the contact and push the ball up the floor.
And then NC State in transition. That was really a big key for them. 11 fast break points in the first half. They also got the ball inside, which I know you like as a post player, Cody.
Absolutely. And what I love about Nene Cote, what she did so well, is she uses her body and her power to back her defender, score those 2 points.
For the Hokies, Shanette Hicks really led the charge in the first quarter, in which they led 20-19. But Virginia Tech got a little sloppy with the basketball in the second quarter. That really helped fuel the Wolfpack run.
That capitalized NC State to get the momentum going. Virginia Tech had to switch defenses and trying to give them something different, but NC State is just capitalizing on those turnovers.
And you see the Wolfpack, after knocking down just 1 3 in the first quarter, they made 3 in the second. That really helped the run. Points in the paint. Big advantage, Wolfpack. And they're also, as you see, a good indicator of whether you're getting into the paint is how many free throws do you take. NC State's winning that battle with 6 more free throws. Again, Virginia Tech averages just about 13 turnovers per game. They've got 7 here in the first, so a little bit higher than their ACC leading average. We've got to take another break, and we'll be back in just a couple of minutes here as we'll start off the second half between NC State and Virginia Tech. That is coming up next. Andrew Sanders and Cody Burke with you here from the City of Oaks, Raleigh, North Carolina, where the 17th-ranked NC State Wolfpack have opened up a 22-point lead at halftime. Just about ready to start the third quarter. Cody, you know Westmore and the Wolfpack are content with how that second quarter went, and really the entire first half with that kind of a lead. I know you've been on both sides of this time of a halftime deficit. When you're the team trailing by 22 and you're in Virginia Tech's shoes, what is the feeling inside the locker room, and what is the message?
You know, there is a little anxiety when you have the defender who's in your face. I know Penny Brooks is telling them to be patient. You see McGarity and Cook, when the ball is fed inside and they patiently score those 2 points, that's what's going well for Virginia Tech. And I think Penny Brooks is going to put an emphasis on that.
Yeah, we saw Virginia Tech, when things got tough, try to get the ball inside. But with Hicks off the floor, that's when the ball was turned over a little bit more. NC State, as we noted when we looked at the halftime stats, the Wolfpack were outscoring the Hokies 24-10 in the paint. So the Pack starts off with the basketball in this third quarter. Again, the Hokies stay in that zone that they previewed in the second. Spencer trying to drive on the bigger McGarity, and she does so with ease.
A lot of that was thanks to Chelsea Nelson's screen in the paint that allowed Mike Spencer to finish right at the rim.
Pass nearly thrown away. Hill able to retrieve it. And now McGarity will put it on the deck, and it knocked away. Hicks playing with those 3 fouls. Wild shot. And Cook keeps it alive. Offensive rebound leads to the basket and a foul.
That's exactly what Virginia Tech needs. Cook to finish inside in the paint, get the momentum going for Virginia Tech.
I think that was a perfect example of what you were talking about, Cody. First it was McGarity trying to get it inside, then Hicks, then Cook. Those are the big 3. And before, I think the ref just might have misspoke, because they blew the whistle just to clarify with the players that there was one shot.
Rather be safe than sorry, Andrew.
Not right, exactly. So Cook converts the three-point play. That'll cut into this NC State lead. And the big three of Virginia Tech, they average, well, about 43 points a game between McGarity and Cook and Hill. Three on the way. Wilson, yes.
That is a down part of when you do play a zone. You leave that three-point shot open, and luckily NC State is converting that as well.
Absolutely. The Wolfpack, 5 of 11 from the bonus sphere. Wilson's got herself another steal, and she dribbled it off the side of her foot. You know, at halftime, Cody, we were discussing how Virginia Tech had 7 turnovers, and that's a little bit uncharacteristic for them, but it felt like more. It felt like they had more. And the reason being, we think, is because they've had a lot of turnovers that have been in the run of play. Ball, not dead ball turnovers, but run-out turnovers like the one we just saw. They've got to cut down on that if they're going to cut into this lead.
Yeah, absolutely. And a lot of that could be giving the defenders a fake and a backdoor cut. That's usually some open opportunities when your defender is denying that reversal.
And NC State has just shown if you turn it over, you know, around the free throw line or so, they're going to punish you and turn it into a layup the other way. Maya Spencer's been doing most of that attacking in transition. This time she just hits a little fundamental shot you don't see anymore. The lost art of the mid-range jumper.
But still admired to this day.
Spencer leads all scorers in the game with 16 points now. And she almost drew a charge. Blocking foul is going to be the call. And that's a big call for Virginia Tech because it was Hicks with the ball. Would have been her fourth. Instead, it's just a foul on Spencer.
Those are always the hardest calls to make. It's those days I don't wish, do not wish I were official.
Sammy Hill still hearing it from the fans about an air ball she had late in the first quarter. Williams reaches in and hacks Brooks.
I can admire Virginia Tech's perimeter players, kind of like NC State, attacking the rim, going for that higher percentage shots and drawing fouls as well.
It's already the third team foul on NC State. Still 7:43 remaining in this third quarter. Brooks makes the first free throw, and Kayla Ely will check in for Ashley Williams because Williams, in fouling Brooks, committed her third foul. Tipped by Cook, corralled by Chelsea Nelson. Haven't seen a lot of her at all. She had those two quick fouls, if you're just tuning in for this second half. She had a couple of fouls within the first couple of minutes of the first quarter.
Yeah, Chelsea Nelson, an interior player that NC State relies on.
Mathurin had her shot blocked. It was McGarity. Now Hicks has the pack backpedaling. And Spencer is going to be called for another foul. She disagrees.
No. Yeah, you have to admire Virginia Tech drawing the contact. That's probably an emphasis that Kenny Brooks told them at the halftime locker room.
It's the second foul on Spencer, both coming in just the last minute. Cook, 10-footer, left it short. A look ahead. Chelsea Nelson runs the floor, but she misses the layup. Hill with the bounce, hands off to Brooks. Cook wants the ball reversed.
Exactly, and that's what they want.
All the execution is there for Virginia Tech except for knocking down the shot.
The final make.
And Cook is pushed. I think she might have caught an elbow to the mouth, but Thurin will get a foul for that one. That's her second foul.
That is the physicality of the ACC. Yeah, you see, oh, that left elbow, yes.
And they're going to go to the monitor for this one. I certainly don't think it was intentional by Mathurin, but because of the letter of the law in college basketball, this might end up being a flagrant. Certainly made clean contact, and we got a good look from our crew there. so we know what the officials are looking at.
Yeah, I agree with you, Ange. I don't think it was intentional, but it is protocol.
It's just the second foul on Mathurin, but this is a situation where NC State has a comfortable lead. Perhaps it will give the Hokies some momentum going forward. We'll see what the ruling is. As you say, there's just physical play in college basketball and in the ACC.
Absolutely, and that's one thing I do miss about playing. You can be knocked down to the floor, but it's fair play.
Both coaches are going to come over, and we'll see if we can judge by the reactions what the call's going to be. Again, we saw a look at that replay. It was certainly an arm right to the chops, as they say. The mouth, the nose of Sidney Cook. And I think, based on the reaction here, it's going to be Cook. And it will be a flagrant. So again, intent doesn't mean that you can avoid getting the flagrant foul. And so that's what the case is going to be. It's a flagrant one as Cook makes the first free throw. Flagrant two is when it was excessive. But contact to the face like that, as we expected, is going to be called a flagrant one. So he gives Virginia Tech a couple of points, and the lead is now 21. And NC State will now have to defend.
Now it's a matter of Virginia Tech protecting the ball and, again, getting the ball inside the paint, because it's those turnovers that give NC State the advantage.
See what Cook has done today. 12 points, 6 of 7 from the floor. Hill with the blow by. Missed it.
Again, Andrew, it kind of goes back to we get so surprised that we're that wide open that just can't convert.
Nelson forced up a shot. Again, they don't mind her getting touches and getting shots, but that's not the shot, the quality of shot that they're really looking for.
Yeah,
Virginia Tech pounds it inside. It's Cook again.
Yeah. Yeah, it's working in Virginia Tech's favor right now.
Come on, rep!
Again, Cook has been excellent. Just missed one shot from the floor. She's gone to the line, where she's 3 of 6. They get 4 of 7. And I thought that foul was going to go against Dee Dee Rogers, but it appears they've given it to Maya Spencer, who has the basketball now. That's 3 fouls on her. She's picked all of them up in just about 4 minutes of the third quarter. So she equals Hicks. That was the story, is that Hicks guarding Spencer had a tough time of it with those 3 fouls, and now they're dead even. Look inside. Maya Spencer, top 5 all-time in NC State assists, and you see why. She's not going to miss the open post player underneath like that.
Oh, no, and such a selfless player, too.
Hill, tough shot.
Backed over 2 defenders, but again, here comes NC State pushing the ball.
Nelson, she's so quick, able to get around many times bigger post players. Spencer will try a 3. It's good.
Don't mind those 3 fouls. Maya's getting it done. She's scoring. She's giving assists. She's pushing the ball. Don't mind those 3 early fouls.
And a turnover from Hicks. Started going a little bit quickly there and threw a poor pass to McGarity towards her feet in the corner. Almost an impossible catch. And it's another turnover for the Hokies. That's now 9 for the visitors from Blacksburg. And NC State leads 61-37 as we take our media timeout for the third quarter. This weekend, NC State softball and Tyler Ross play host to Michigan and Minnesota in this year's ACC Big Ten Challenge. First pitch is at 5 p.m. on Friday. It'll be streaming live on the ACC Network Extra and watch ESPN. Here in Reynolds Coliseum, alongside Cody Burke, I'm Andrew Sanders. Both NC State and Virginia Tech won their matchups in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, which is always so fun to be a part of, both on the men's and women's side of college basketball. Virginia Tech and Kenny Brooks, you know, NC State has committed 5 fouls in this quarter. The Hokies have committed none. They had the flagrant foul, which led to a couple of free throws. The Hokies have been able to get to the line, but the feeling of the game during that break was that the Hokies were starting to catch up, but even though they've gotten the ball inside and gotten to the line, they have not been able to make any progress on the score here, trailing by 24.
Right. A couple of the interior points were wild shots, should I say, and not good quality shots, which would effectively help Virginia Tech at this point.
And NC State certainly hasn't been as good offensively as it was in the second quarter. It's been good enough to keep that advantage, hovering just over 20 points. After the Brooks missed, it was last touched by NC State. Good spin, no finish from DeAndre DeRosa, playing in the second half for the first time. And NC State is able to just counter punch so quickly off the defensive boards.
In that possession, pick your poison. Maya Spencer attacking the rim or Dominique Wilson wide open the three-point line.
Experience is such a luxury, and this NC State team has it in spades, really. There's an answer the other way. Kendall Brooks with the three.
Virginia Tech back to that man-to-man defense now.
Another three. Not this time from Wilson. Fight for the rebound. And it eventually goes to McGarity. Rosa Jr. from Pawtucket, Rhode Island. So again, this is not a tremendously deep Hokies team in Coach Brooks' first year. Benusis will score. Really a solid rotation of about 7 players. But DeRosa seeing a couple of spot minutes. She's the 9th Hokie to play in this game. Maya Spencer, another Wolfpack three.
And Maya Spencer is doing it all, giving assists and scoring. She's having a fantastic game so far.
DeRosa answers with a long two. Pretty much standard operating procedure for NC State. The team averages 8 made threes per game. They've got 7 so far. 7 of 14, 50%.
I'll take 50% from the three-point line any day.
Nelson, 15-footer, too much. Looking to go to McGarity. Second effort, can she grab the board? Yes, she can. She'll go up again, great effort.
Second chance points and converting on those. And that's exactly what Virginia Tech wants. They want to get the ball inside for the high percent shots. Now it's just a matter of taking good quality shots to finish at the rim.
And with Shanette Hicks out of the game, Sydney Cook is also out waiting to check back in. So McGarity is their best offensive option. She knew it, put her head down, and got him too. Spencer, blow by.
Right by her defender. Excellent box out by both Nelson and Spencer.
Wilson is fouled. They're going to get Penusis, I believe. Pardon me, it's going to go against McGarity.
Dominique Wilson, who, like Maya Spencer, is very quick in attacking the rim, draws a foul. And Wilson, a good free throw shooter. Let's see if she converts.
Foul not on McGarity. I thought they signaled number 11. Instead, it was number 10, Kendall Brooks. McGarity comes out, as does Brooks. Cook back in.
You can anticipate Virginia Tech trying to give Cook the ball inside offensively with this lineup.
Wilson makes another. Can't say enough about NC State offensively today. 71 points. That's about what they average.
And it's only the third quarter?
Absolutely.
I wonder if they could break 100. They keep playing defense like that.
Three from DeRosa. Short, good board by Hill. Lost it on the way up. Ah, Wilson had nice hands getting in there.
But what a board by Hill, though. She was up there, stretched her arms long, and grabbed that rebound.
NC State averaging, to be very specific, 71.1 points per game. Virginia Tech, basically the exact same, 71.7. Loose ball. Mays has got it. And she was fouled, they say. They're going to get DeRosa.
You can respect Virginia Tech is trying to get after the ball, deny reversals, as NC State is doing with them
sure.
defensively.
It might just be too little too late to turn up that defensive pressure. I mean, it wasn't without effort that second quarter, as we noted at the time, Coach Brooks had them change from man to zone. He threw a 2-2-1 trap in there as well. And yet NC State, no matter what it saw, handled it just fine.
Yeah. A lot of that goes to veteran leadership as well, understanding the game, knowing when to make the right decisions.
Inside, Mays misses. From just a couple of feet out. They go to Cook. And Rogers with the contact.
Again, with this lineup for Virginia Tech, I would have expected they would have looked to Cook to score that final shot.
So a good opportunity for Cook, because she had Mays in front of her. A wall defensively. Instead, she'll get to go to the free throw line. Makes the first. With just 1 second left, she was kind of out of time to make a move there. She was going to have to force it up over Mays. That'll do it. Three quarters are in the books in Reynolds Coliseum. NC State led by 22 at halftime. It leads by 24 as we go into the fourth quarter. Virginia Tech trying to get a marquee road win, but they have dug themselves a big hole here away from home. We'll see if they can pull off a miracle comeback when we return on the ACC Network Extra. Start of the fourth quarter here in Raleigh between Virginia Tech and NC State. This has been a matchup that the Wolfpack has dominated over the years. This is the 18th meeting. NC State is 16-1 and look poised to make it 17-1, barring an outstanding fourth quarter from Virginia Tech. And Cody, when we look at the Hokies and why they've fallen into this deficit, it's hard to look past their best player in Shanann Hicks, and you look at the score sheet, just 4 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 turnovers, and only 1 steal for the star. She's been so severely limited with foul trouble.
Absolutely, and that's taken a toll on Virginia Tech, who looks to Hicks as a leader, and Hicks mentally may be feeling that nothing could be going her way.
Foul inside as the Hokies will shoot a couple of free throws. They shot several free throws in that third quarter. You see the emphasis from Coach Brooks that actually lost the third quarter by 2 points. And Wes Moore wants a timeout here. One possession in. He didn't like what he saw, and that is the first called timeout by a coach in the second half. So that means it's going to be a full timeout, a media timeout. So we'll go right back to break and be back in a couple of minutes here. 71-47, Hokies at the line when we return. Here with Cody Burke, I'm Andrew Sanders. Glad you could join us here. Just got started in the fourth quarter, and one possession in. NC State fouled Virginia Tech number 14, Kayla Kinder. And Wes Moore did not like it, Cody. He called timeout, something he didn't like defensively from the pack there.
Yeah, that's a typical Coach Moore. He could be winning by 50 points, but there's one thing that he does not like, the whole world.
He says, hold on, stop everything.
Yes.
Can't have that happen. We came back from break. We just had the second horn. And that was a full timeout. Seemed a little more full than normal. Missed free throw by Kinder.
You see Lucky Rudd getting minutes in. Maya Spence on the bench. Great opportunity for her to increase her credibility.
Kinder missed both free throws. Did a nice job trying to follow her shot and swipe the ball away from Mays. Walked. Once you take those two steps like that, you've got to go up with it.
Have to go up.
This is the only meeting this year between NC State and Virginia Tech, at least on the women's basketball court. But they might meet again in the ACC tournament. That starts March 1st in Conway, South Carolina. March 1st through the 5th, NC State is hoping to start its tournament on March 3rd.
And I share with you, Andrew, it's anybody's title at this point in the ACC.
It really is, because when we looked at the standings earlier, and you look at the teams that are ahead of NC State, well, they beat Notre Dame, their only loss in conference. They beat Florida State, their only loss in conference. And beat Duke, who has three losses, as DeRosa, I think she might have gotten away with the travel there.
She may have gotten away, but nonetheless, it's 2 points for Virginia Tech, which they need at this point.
Absolutely. And as we saw earlier, talking about ACC tournament seeding, as Wilson knocks down a pretty jumper. NC State will be favored in the rest of its games. Obviously, you can't take them for granted, but will be favorites to go. They could finish as good as 13-3 in the conference, which would be remarkable for a team that was picked seventh in the preseason. It just goes to show you, preseason expectations don't really count for a whole lot.
They sure don't. I know NC State at this point would love that two-day bye in the ACC tournament, give them fresh legs to claim the title.
Virginia Tech, remember, just a couple of games out of eight as Wilson is starting to heat up. Just a couple of games outside of that eighth spot, and that's really a key, because you don't want to play on that opening day of the conference tournament. Panousis will get the roll. And again, Virginia Tech has some winnable games down the stretch at Pittsburgh. Virginia at home looking for revenge. Miami at home is tough, but again, it's senior night. I need some extra energy for that one as Mays misses. And then at Boston College on February 26th, McGarity running the floor nicely. The pass just a bit too tall for her.
That would have been a great run for Virginia Tech.
Erica Cassell, Nene Cole come in for the pack as Rogers and Mays check out.
And Nene Cole, who had an excellent first half, this is a great opportunity for her to fill up her stats a little bit more.
Lucky Rudd, way too strong on the three. And right now, NC State the 25-point lead. Coach Moore is playing some lesser-used players. And as you say, great experience because you want to be able to have that depth, especially when you get down to tournament time. If a couple of players get in foul trouble, or heaven forbid you have an injury,
right,
this experience could prove to be huge.
Absolutely, because playing 3 or 4 days straight, very wearing on your body.
No doubt about it. Cook goes to the line. Foul is on Erica Cassell. Just her first foul. She's only been in the game for about a minute. For this Virginia Tech team that, again, Charlie Cream of ESPN came out with his women's basketball bracketology, said they're in the next four out right now. You got to figure, as long as something crazy doesn't happen the rest of the way here, they'll be 3-9 in conference. But, again, with those four games remaining, if they can go, say, 3-1 out of those four, 6-10 in conference, you got to figure that's going to be awfully tough to make the tournament unless you can go on a deep run in the ACC tournament. But the next one, obviously you take it one game at a time, the old cliche, and it's true. But the next one that they can really circle on their calendar, that senior day matchup February 23rd against Miami at home, they get a statement win there. That would really boost that resume. Lucky Rudd got poked in the eye. She'll go to the line.
Andrew, it does go back to show how powerful the ACC is in women's basketball.
Sure.
Because right now, if you're, you know, you win only three games, but still in a good standing to get into the NCAA tournament.
And it's impossible to have a better resume than Virginia Tech in the non-conference. They were 13-0. And granted, some teams had a harder strength of schedule, but they beat a ranked Tennessee team. They beat Nebraska in the ACC Big Ten Challenge.
It was Georgetown, Auburn.
Yeah.
Quality wins.
Very quality wins.
One more would solidify the deal, let's see.
Another Hokies turnover trying to get it inside to Cooks. No, it's going to stay here. My mistake. When you're on the road, I know Hicks is just a sophomore, but when the leader of your team has a rough effort on the road, it's awfully tough to get a win.
Absolutely. No matter what class you're in, when your leader is not in sync, it's hard to get out of that funk.
What we've seen, though, is that Sydney Cook, the second leading scorer, has stepped up nicely. And again, this is really part of the big three, as people say around basketball. Cook has 10 double-doubles on the year. Needs four more rebounds to get a double-double here today.
Yeah, I love how Cook stepped up, knowing that, as we mentioned, Hicks is not performing as she'd like, so someone else has to step up. Cook has been doing that well.
Offensively, Virginia Tech certainly below its average. But the story for me, as NC State gets a wide-open layup, the story for me has been the quality of the Wolfpack's offense. Three from Brooks goes down, but it's still a 23-point lead, and the Wolfpack 79 points. I mean, I know Virginia Tech has had breakdowns at time, but correct me if I'm wrong, Cody, at least to my eye, the defense hasn't been horrible from the Hokies today at all.
No, not at all. It goes back to what you said, just good quality offense, scoring inside, outside, giving points. As Nene Cole does.
Coach Wes Moore has himself a pretty special team here in Raleigh this year.
Yeah, it's amazing what he's just done to the program, getting NC State back to that winning condition. Winning tradition as it was under Kay Yao's legacy.
When you look down the roster, and we've seen some of the moves and the scoring capability of a player like Nene Cole, who has the basketball now. And Cole is a young player. And are they going to get Cassell, I believe, with a moving screen? Or perhaps it was Cole. Either way, that's the under five timeout. So we'll take our final break here in Reynolds Coliseum. NC State 81, Virginia Tech 58 as the Wolfpack trying to improve to 9-3 in conference play. Syracuse at the Carrier Dome in the first one at 7 p.m. Eastern. Then when we're done there, it's number 13, West Virginia, and number 3, Kansas at the Fog. Big Monday presented by eBay on ESPN. Also streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. Andrew Sanders, Cody Burke with you here in Reynolds Coliseum. The Wolfpack band is rocking. It's a good crowd in here for a Sunday afternoon to watch NC State and Virginia Tech, and this home crowd has been delighted to see some really nice offensive play. The Wolfpack already with 10 points more than its average, still 4 minutes to go. We've seen the scoring, and now we see the defense from the youngster.
Exactly. Again, earning her credibility. And you mentioned earlier, you know, she's a sophomore. And Nene Cole compliment Chelsea Nelson next year is a good outlook for the program.
Saw on the bench, Akilah Mays had a nice reaction to that. She really enjoys the defense from Nene.
Nothing but love for the teammate.
And that's part of the depth. Nene Cole showing up in this game. Spoke of DeeDee Rogers, who gave NC State 28 great minutes when Mathurin was in foul trouble at Georgia Tech, a game that went into overtime. So they're getting contributions from all over as shot is made by Vanessa Panousis. And then, as good as this NC State team has been, that five-star point guard, Aislinn Koenig, who had a foot injury, she's been out for the last month or so. They're hoping to get her back towards the end of the regular season, if not, you know, March 1st, 2nd, 3rd, somewhere in there for the ACC tournament. So this is an NC State team that is poised for a big run.
Yeah, absolutely, and you need those fresh legs going into the postseason.
And if they can get Koenig back healthy, the deep get even deeper. Ely, spin move. Well, that's pretty.
Excellent up and under by Kayla Ely. And now she's another person who has a great outlook for the program as well. Very excited about NC State women's basketball in the future.
Both of these programs have such a bright outlook. And really, when you have that, players and coaches will always tell you this, Cody. Players win games, as Minucius knocks down a three. But when you have that consistency and year after year success, it's because of the coaching. These two programs both have very bright head coaches.
Yeah, absolutely. And they both moved into the ACC from mid-majors, made their mark in the mid-majors.
That's a good point you bring up. Wes Moore coming from UT Chattanooga. One of the winningest coaches, really, in women's college basketball there. He's got over 600 career wins. DeRosa makes it from about 18 feet. And then we spoke about Kenny Brooks and his time, and James Madison in 11 years. He's their all-time winningest coach. So,
Coach Moore arguably probably the top candidate for ACC Coach of the Year this year.
I think you could certainly make that argument, especially when you knock off all of the teams that are ahead of you in the standings. You throw in a road win that they just had at Louisville. And it's awfully tough if you're picked preseason first in the conference. It's hard to win Coach of the Year, even if you just live up to expectations. But when you're picked seventh, and again, they have a chance to finish fourth, maybe third if they catch Duke. And they'll be moving ahead of Duke as long as they hold on in this one. Up 20 with a minute and 10 left, because they have the tiebreaker over the Blue Devils. And again, they'll be favored the rest of the way. So NC State looking a good bet to be that three seed, really, in the tournament. Looking far down the road, that would lead to a semis matchup if the seeds hold with number two Florida State. And remember, NC State won in Tallahassee. So this is I think some of the prognosticators picking this team as maybe the best dark horse bet in the ACC tournament to come out and win, because, you know, everybody knows that how dominant Notre Dame has been.
Right.
It's easy to pick Notre Dame, but if you're picking a dark horse, you might not need to look any further than this ACC team in NC State.
Right.
Count the basket. Nene Cole commits the foul. Virginia Tech with a couple of late baskets going to finish right around where they average, just a hair under 72 points a game. And NC State pouring it on to the tune of 85 points here this afternoon.
And a lot of that goes to NC State pushing the ball, and you have to give credit for them scoring offensively in many ways, inside, outside.
This Wolfpack team had a little scoring drought a couple of weeks ago against Duke, Clemson, Pittsburgh. And really, you could even say against North Carolina. But as we've reached mid-February, looking to round into form at just the right time.
And it's funny, Andrew, even in those three of those four games where they had a scoring drought, they were still wins for NC State.
You know, on a day like today where it's almost 80 degrees in Raleigh, it kind of reminds you that, hey, spring is just around the corner. And that with that comes March Madness. Panousis knocks down another three. And that should be our final basket here this afternoon. NC State with an 85-71 win over Virginia Tech. The Wolfpack have won sixth of its last seven in the ACC. Virginia Tech has now lost eight straight, as the Pack are now 9-3, the Hokies 3-9. Cody, your final thoughts from today's contest?
You have to give credit to NC State for pushing the ball. That is what they're good at. They're a team of runs, and they knocked down the three, scored in the interior. Excellent win for the Wolfpack.
The Wolfpack, 17th in the country. They got a couple of nice road wins at Louisville and Georgia Tech, and they return home victorious here against the Hokies. Maya Spencer led the way, 23 points for her, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists. That'll do it for us here in Raleigh, our great crew, and my partner Cody Burke. I'm Andrew Sanders saying so long, where the final score, NC State 85, Virginia Tech 71. This has been a presentation of ESPN.